How long term is a 2-year yield for you right now?
Well, I think one of the amazing things is, you know, we've seen a backup of 100 basis points in 2-year yields over the past 6 months or so. We have 1-year T-bill yields now above 2% yield for the first time in more than a decade. So right now, front end rates with the flattening of the yield curve seem relatively attractive place to hide at.
What does it do to Steve Eisman's world? I mean, all of a sudden the cost of money's there and it filters through, it anchors through the system as well. Jerome Schneider, what does it do to Steve's world?
A very important point, this is missed oftentimes, is looking at the liability side of the equation for assets. Over the past 6 months, a year, we've seen funding spreads actually remain static and steady compared to where asset spreads have been. So for funding for hard assets has been relatively competitive and has gotten more competitive, but hasn't really recalibrated. As rates move higher, as nominal rates move higher, it's obviously going to become more difficult to finance and hit those ROE targets from some perspectives. So one other point to really make here is that financing spreads, or the cost of financing over LIBOR, generally doesn't recalibrate as quickly as the asset spreads do along the way. And so don't expect a widening as quickly when that financing cost increase, although the nominal rate will clearly increase along the way.
Jerome, what did you hear from Jay Powell yesterday? What was the main, you know, was it that we're going for 4 hikes, or was it just that the tone will shift and that the U.S. economy is doing much better than expected?
I heard optionality. Preserve our optionality along the way. Recognize the fact that it's most likely 3, maybe 4 hikes. He was speaking his own opinion clearly along the way, but he hasn't really gotten fully around the table in terms of what the entire board is going to be thinking about at that point in time when they meet in March for the revised SEP and DOT revisions. But from an important point of view, to me, what it really said was, hey, pay attention to that. Front-end rates are moving higher. Embrace these higher rates moving higher. And the market, you market participants, need to be paying attention to the fact that ultimately rates in 2019 and 20, if these conditions continue to improve and that financial conditions remain static or relatively easy, the Fed is going to continue with the response function that we've seen for the better part of the past few years. So understand that this is going to continue for some time, and the market should be on its toes to really expect perhaps recalibration in rates beyond 2018 and looking to 2019.
Okay, so Jerome, if you look at the 10-year yield, does it go above 3% quickly? And what does it do once it's above 3%?
So obviously, clearly volatility is going to be emanating from the marketplace as we look to recalibrate front-end rates and the yield curve flattens. It's very important to look at that. As we get to higher rates, to 3% beyond, naturally you're going to have more buyers, more demand emerge in the market. So it's not going to be a static flip from 3% to 3.25 and beyond, but it's something that's simply going to be iterative along the way. But it's going to propel volatility.